How do you deal with fear of talking to someone about your business? Hello, Gordon Attar here. Welcome to this video. Excited to have you here watching this and questions that are coming in. Thanks so much for those questions. If you have a question about network marketing, how can I serve you? Is just typing your question in the comments below, or maybe you can reach out to me on social media and maybe you want to ask your question privately. That's fine with me, and send me your question there. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do. And also make sure you click on the notification bell, so once I release more videos about this on my channel, you will be notified. So we're gonna talk about fear in this video. I love this question, and this is something that I have struggled in the beginning so much. So my friend, if you have asked your question, this question, do not feel alone of having fear to talk about your business. That's a lot of people in the beginning for sure. So this is what it's all about. In my opinion, it's all about being confident and being much more in belief to what you have, which is your business, the opportunity, the whole network marketing field. The reason why you have fear is because you have lack of belief and also lack of skills. So having more belief, it builds confidence, right? So going to events builds your skills, and also doing the business on a day-to-day basis builds the skills. So the reason why you have that mindset of fear, okay, it is a false evidence that appears real, okay? That's what fear means. So it is a false evidence that you're putting out there, okay, in the universe, and this is why you're not gonna be moving, okay? You're not gonna be moving and doing the business what you should do, right? So make my recommendation to you is this: do not focus on what can happen. You can be lost in, oh, what if this my laptop breaks down? Oh, what if I don't have enough battery? These are the kind of things that will put more pressure to your fear, right? So be confident, okay? If you're not that confident yet, try to work on that. Work on being confident. So you can ask your sponsor on how they can help you, or maybe your upline, how can you be much more confident? Okay, so you can walk different if you dress up. When I do presentations, like locally, or maybe when I'm present there, I like to dress up. So once you dress up, you already feel confident, don't you think? If you dress like a nice jacket, doesn't have to be with a tie, but if you have a shirt and maybe a blazer and shoes, you already feel confident. So if you go and work out with a tracksuit, like going and show someone a tracksuit, you feel like lazy, kind of like. So that someone can help you. Dress up for your dress up for the presentation. Dress up and show up. This is what leaders do. You want to be a servant leader? Definitely, this is the right way. Doesn't matter your age, your background, where you're from. You need to go against your fear. You need to go against your fear to talk with someone about your business. So this first impression does count. Nowadays we're living in that bubble as well, so you've got to dress up. Doesn't matter again what is your age, find a way how to be a servant leader, how to become a servant leader at the end of the day. So being confident, second thing is belief. If you don't believe yet, if you're trying to do something with this opportunity, you're not gonna win. You've got to believe, and the reason how you can raise your belief is by attending events, listening to calls, listening to audios, okay, listening to your sponsor and upline, because they are the leaders, they are your leaders. This is how you increase belief. Never negotiate events. A lot of people do. Unfortunately, this is why they're not successful. You've got to never ever negotiate events, because you, at the end of the day, you will stay where you are, and your belief level stays where it's at. So number three is, so I talked about being confident, belief, and also using the product. Using the product will help you have stories that you can share It's all about sharing, right? Sharing your story, sharing your why, sharing stories, other stories that will help someone in the business. Because if they ask you a question and you can say, hey, I completely understand where you're coming with this, but friend of mine, he's a student. He's studying university, he's like you, he's 20 years of age, and although he's studying, he's doing this on a part-time basis, and he's already making $500 if he's doing that every month with us. So they will start thinking, I said, oh, it's possible. There's a team, there's a support. This is how they start digging deep, and probably they join you. So do not let fear stop you from where you want to go, okay? Attack fear, build confidence by doing the work, connect with your sponsor, if they can help you, give you some slots or maybe things that can that you can elevate your confidence, and also I believe in these things, skills. That's the other thing, is improve your skill set. When you improve your skill set, the fear fades away. So improve your skills, okay? And the rest, fear fades away. If you have got value out of this, make sure to share this around. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do click on the notification bell as well, so you'll be notified on the new videos that I have prepared for you. That's all I have for you. Leave the comment below if you like this, if you also maybe have a different take and twist on this. Okay, what would you do if you have fear of showing somebody? Okay, let me know. It will be interesting to see in the comments below. That's all I have for you. This is Gordon Attard. I'm signing off. Thanks once again. Take it to the top, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.